Oh, yes. Ah, it feels so good. Oh, yeah. Thank you for the sponge bath, Nurse Potato. I really appreciate it. I needed it after being in the hospital for so long.
Oh, wait. Wait, everything's fading. Wait, what's going on? Oh, no. Another dream. Yeah, hello everyone, and welcome back to the walkthrough. Wait for it. Wait for it. There it is. Dorman's next message. The next place that we're going to be going to is pretty far off. It's way at the upper left corner of the map. But there's multiple ways to get to it, excuse me. So, the pathway that I'm going to be taking, you don't have to take per se, but it's just going to be the path that I'm going to be taking to collect stuff along the way. There's not all that much to collect along the way or anything like that. I just want to knock it off as long as I'm going down this way, because I'm going to end up down the other paths for other Colossi some other ways, and why did I do that? I don't know. So yeah, that's why I am going to be taking the path that I will be taking this part. I know that was very descriptive, but you will see what path I will be taking. And by path I will be taking, I mean, I'm going to go around this temple here, and you'll see that the light points you like somewhere around there. But we're actually going to take this bridge over here under this broken arc. At least I think, yeah, that's correct. Oops, okay. yeah, I just wanted to check my map there to make sure I was taking the right bridge to said area. I wouldn't want to go to the left part of the map, because that's not where I want to go here. I want to cross this bridge once again, because you know how this bridge is. We've been through here before, you know how to get here. But we're going to go even further down the pathway that we took on the higher route, except this time straight north. And we're also going to be following the bridge. Remember that super large bridge at the start of the game? Yeah, we're actually going to be checking that out for realsies. Well, we can't actually go on top of it. But I'll be using it as sort of a landmark, I guess you could say. I always like doing landmarks in my walkthroughs because it's very difficult if you cut too much out for people to follow. Because it's like, okay, I'm over here. And then people are trying to match up this particular grain of sand pattern. And yeah, you get what I'm saying here. Or, you know, I would like to, if I have to do more cuts than usual, I would cut to show where I am on the map, like so and whatnot. But anyway, what I'm going to be going to do is going over to that save temple over there, because thar be a lizard. And I be getting that lizard. Hopefully. I wonder if I should climb up to it, because I'm pretty sure it hangs out near the top, if I recall correctly. You know this. Oh, wait, I see it, I see it, I see it, see it, I see it, I see it. Whoa, I think I got it! Yes! Yes! And I'm not going to save my game here, because this isn't going to be a multi-parter like before. At least, I don't think. At the very least, I will do some cuts to save some time and whatnot, but I don't think that's going to be even necessary in all honesty. Oh, there it is. I was going to say, where'd the lizard tail go? Alright, there we go. Got it. And now let's do our traditional check out the area by climbing up to the top dealio here. Like so. Not much more to go. As I said, these things are structured virtually the same overall, so yeah. It's like a copy pasta shrine. And there we go! Take a look at that bridge. Awesome sauce. Anyway, we're going to be going over to that rock right over there on the other side of the bridge. Don't mind the fall damage, we'll be healed along the way. No, wait, I was going to say, where did Algro go? Anyway, we're going to be healed along the way as we ride there. Anyway, so fall damage means nothing to me. See, we're healing already. Feeling better, just need a little horseback riding to get the blood pumping. Alright, I see the lizard now. It was up over, yep, right there. Whoop, oh, I got it, yeah! Making good progress quick enough. Now watch it run away from me. Nah. Alright, there we go. Let's get back on our faithful steed and head back over to the other side of the bridge, because I'm going to be aiming for some fruit trees. Fruit trees. And yeah, they are indeed on that side, so yeah. Let's just keep going down this desert that is oddly not slowing aggro down at all, because, you know, the hooves would probably sink in the sand, or at least you would think, but no, that doesn't happen. See those trees up ahead? Yep, those are what I am going for. There's four pieces of fruit over there. And you know I'm gonna get all of them. All of them. And then on the other side of the bridge, once again, there's another lizard. But let's focus on the fruit right here, right now, shall we? The three are in big tree here. I see one there. It's always a hide and seek. And there's one there. So there's two. I probably can't see the other ones because leaves are in the way. Wait, is this one? No, it is not. Okay. Let's go on the other side here. I know their locations, don't worry. And they won't, like, despawn unless I go too far away. And if they do despawn, they're just going to go back up in the tree. Ah, there we go. Three and four. Let's get to snacking. Yes! Feel the power flowing through your veins. And, where's the... Ying, ying. It felt here, didn't it? Like, seriously? Oh, wait, there it is. Dang fruit being partially in objects. And the last one was right here. There we go. Got all of our num-nums. We can move on to a bit on this side. Don't trip on the rocks, Sagro. I don't remember exactly where this lizard was. I think it was at another sort of kind of like landmark. I'm not positive. Maybe it was here. Because I see this rock is here, and oh, yep, there it is, okay. I'm glad I didn't move a little bit I didn't move too far away from here. Oh, no, stop. Okay, you can go on the wall, you're easy to shoot there. Alright! Making excellent progress. Now watch, the recording is going to corrupt just because. Aggro! Come back here! Fine, I might as well start walking over to the next spot. I want to go down this way here, but Aggro will eventually catch up. Oh, there it is. I want to go down... let me on! Thank you. I want to go down this path right here. Down the desert. There isn't anything to get until the next save temple that we see, so we can just pretty much continue along this path pretty blindly. But, you know, I'm gonna sort of pan the camera around so you can see and stuff like that, the beauty of this desert-like area. And, yeah, you know, it is a desert. It's not a desert-like. It is most certainly a desert. But, yeah. And right after the save temple will be the next Colossus. You know, straight up ahead after the save temple, which is delightful. See, I can wave out my sword, I think. Yep, straight ahead. See that? Yep. So go! There's the save temple right there. This land is really vast, by the way, so it's a lot to search through. Let me tell you. Alright, oh, this save temple looks maybe slightly different because of the tree down below, but anyway, let's find where the lizard hangs out, where the lizard roams free. Not sure exactly where, because it, you know, it roams around, it loves to sniff the ground just because, likes to run around in circles just because, that's what lizards do, apparently. Where is that bugger? It's gotta be around here somewhere. Maybe it's under the ark. Sometimes they like to hang out around here. Nope. It's probably going around the same direction that I'm going around, and that's why I'm not seeing it. just how things would probably go with me. Wait. Oh, I thought that was the lizard up there, but that's just some leaves. Oh, there you are. Aha! I'm getting the hang of shooting you guys, aren't I? Wait, where did you plop down to? Where did you... What? 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 you see me shoot it? Or did I not shoot it and did I just stun it? Like, is it still alive walking around here somewhere? But I don't see... It's taily-tail... Oh, over there? Really? It doesn't seem like where it would fall from, but well, whatever. Maybe it was just... I don't know, maybe I wasn't paying attention to the perspective or something like that. How do I get up to... Not this side. I was gonna say, how do I get up to the top? Keep going, I guess. Oh, shoot. I'm glad I was holding R1 there. Alright. I should say, I'm glad I was holding R1 there before I started falling past the part, because I would have plummeted and I would have to recline. Well, not plummeted, you know, it's still a... It's not a far drop or anything like that, but it's an inconvenient drop. There we go. Gotta get our view of the area, of course. Because why not? Look at that, even the chip on the side of these temples, like over there, is virtually the same as the other ones. Anyway. There we go. Your view is breathtaking. In such a barren land. Alright, let's go. Aggro! Okay, we're good. We're good. Broken legs will heal, and did I get turned around here? Where is next? That away? Hold on, I'll check the map. Yeah, that's right. Okay. Just wanted to be sure. Because it looked like the homing light there was split apart a little bit there. Kind of weird. Anyway, next Colossus. Just up ahead. And it's going to be like, I mean, unlike any other Colossus you've seen before. And whoops, I wanted to jump over something, but I jumped a little too early. I'm sorry. It's going to... Oh, well, whatever. Let's go in here, and... Horse. 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 Yes, no! No, it's kind of tricky to do these little turns, that's why I'm like, horse. Alright, there we go. We got ourselves a cutscene. Woo! Just a brief cutscene. Nothing too big, nothing too spectacular, but anyway, I'm gonna go climb up to the top of that spiral there just for kicks, I suppose. I'm gonna dismount here, I suppose. Yeah, that seems like a good idea. And plop down here, do some platforming. Yeah! Okay. The reason why I want to go up here is because I want to get a view of the area as well, just like I've been doing lately. So, let's do so, shall we? It's not that long of a trek. Some leaves growing around there, and hey there. What's this edge? There appears to be a platform down there. Could it be directing me to a particular platform? Let's find out. Woo! There's the Colossus! See that sparkle in the water? Well, you might not have seen the whole thing, of course. Say hello to Hydras, the Electric Eel Colossus. Yeah! Underwater battle! Well, kind of. You'll see what I mean when I get into it. Because it's electric, it makes you think that you want to stay on some sort of surface to get away from it and, like, shoot at it from a distance or something like that. But that's not helpful at all, actually. What you want to do is approach it and try and get on its tail. So watch its tail and just follow it around there. You'll eventually get into a spot that it'll be like, yeah, I'll just put my tail above the water here, and then you can climb up on it if you would like to. Although maybe it's not so willing as I'm making it sound, but you know, it's what you gotta do. It's what the game is hinting at, maybe not so much the Colossus. Alright, so let's get it going here. It should eventually start trying to zap me, because I'm just above it. Okay, it's gonna flip up to the surface around here. I can see the electricity is popping up here. And get ready to grab the tail! Yo! Got it! And the battle begins. Of course, you know, do not get zapped by the electricity and all like that, but that, I think that much is obvious, because, you know, humans, pretty vulnerable to that sort of thing, and yeah. Anyway, you gotta wait for it to start surfacing a little bit. It takes a little bit of time here, but when you are able to actually walk onto it, you'll be able to recover your stamina, and it always seems to give you enough time to recover your stamina by it going to the surface. Like, it's about to surface right about now, and then we... Oops! It didn't surface. Whoopsie! I dropped off of it. But you get the concept of it, right? 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 Got it? Good. Okay, let's move on here and try and grab its tail again. It's kind of slow swimming, so I can kind of catch up with it like so. Yeah, although it's not above the surface, so I can't grab onto its tail. But I can catch up with it relatively easily. Oh, it spotted me, because it made a sound. Uh-oh. Get ready to grab the tail! Get ready for Taylor! I'm gonna switch the camera around, because I have an easier time grabbing it when I'm at about this angle here. Ah, pain! I got zapped. Okay, get ready to hold R1. There we go. And we're on again. Now, if only I can get this bad boy to surface a little bit, that would be pretty nice, because I gotta run up to its segments, basically. While it's underwater, I can't really run, so all I can do is hang on. And that's not the most convenient of things. Oh, there we go. See, when it goes up to the surface, you can move along its body just by walking on it. It's not like gonna throw you off or anything like that. It only throws you off when it's in the water. So yeah, just gotta pick your opportunities and go with it. I don't know why I wasn't going up to the surface before. Maybe because I was too close to the tail tip or something, and I messed up its usual animations and whatnot. But, well, it's doing it properly now, so... Well, what else can I do but just press on? Now, if you try and get past those electric feelers, well, you're gonna take a ton of damage for them. So what you want to do is disable those feelers. To do so, you've got to have your sword out so that you can see the weak points, and go up to the front here so you can see the bluish-green stuff, and stab it, and then back away before it washes you away! Oh god, oh god, oh god, oh god, oh god. It's gonna zap me. It's gonna zap me. Oh, what didn't zap me? Oh, okay, I disabled it quick enough. Good. Very good. Okay, I thought it was gonna zap me, because I didn't know if I did enough damage to it. They don't have a real good indication as to how much damage it takes for those suckers to get disabled. But, just do as much as you can per strike. And it looks like I got that one, too. When they turn black, that's how you know when they're disabled, and then you can move on. And go, 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 go! Oh god, oh god, oh god, I need to grab some fluff! Or whatever the heck is attached to its body. Maybe it's LJ or something. Alright, get back to the surface so I can start running closer to the other one. Come on, come on, bad boy, come on! Okay, it's turning up. See, I can't, like, move forward while it's moving around underwater like that. There's just too much underwater movement, and... Oh, no, it didn't let me. Oh! Well, I guess I gotta walk back up to the front again. Maybe it was so descriptive that I had to redo it from the start. I don't know, I don't think so, though. I think I just got unlucky again. Whoop! Just barely got on it there. Sure makes things a whole lot easier when you've got those zappy things gone, huh? Yeah! You can run right up to the front almost immediately. Well, maybe not almost immediately, but you get what I'm saying here. Disable it! Yes, I got it. Alright, now for its main weak point right here on its noodle. Alright, here we go. You know where this is going. Don't fight it any longer, eel man. Urgh! Wow, I did a lot of damage there. Maybe I can do one more sword strike like that, and... Oh, I was a little bit late. Just a little bit late before I went in the water. Come on, come on, come on. Yo! Come Come on! Almost got this! Almost got it! And another one goes down the drain. Please, no black tentacly things. Please, I'm begging you. I'm begging you. Man, for a fish, it sure sinks when it dies. Fish are known to float when they die, and oh, forget it. In fact, living things are known to die, and I mean, living things are known to float in general because their bodies are less buoyant. I mean, they're more buoyant. You know, it's less mass in the water, and you get what I'm saying here. So they automatically go to the surface and whatnot. So yeah. Anyway, it appears that this part is over. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next part.